Sorry for the delay, everybody. Thank you for being patient, and thank you for being here with me today. Welcome to Scotch and Smoke Rings, episode 397. I am your friendly neighborhood Oxhorn here, as always, without my suspenders. Oh no, I don't know where they're at. Cheers, ladies and gentlemen. Time for a Belgian. We have a great show planned today. We're going to be doing more of the railroad quests. I have been working on my new railroad character a little bit. I gained one more level on her, so I think she's level 11, something like that. And we are going to go, we just finished Boston After Dark and Ticonderoga, I believe. And so now we need to do Butcher's Bill. We're going to be doing some of those Butcher's Bill quests, which is going to be a lot of fun. But before we do anything, ladies and gentlemen, as we always begin each episode of Scotch and Smoke Rings, we must fire up a cigar. Today I'm smoking a La Aurora y Leon Corojo, which has become a staple here on Scotch and Smoke Rings. And you know what? I need to tell everyone on Discord that I'm streaming right now. I almost forgot. There we go. All right, let's add the magic ingredient. Fire. Chris Reese says, Oxhorn, riddle me this. Could God create a rock so heavy that he can't lift it? 42. Jack the Dankster says, the Railroad is probably my favorite faction out of all of them. The Railroad is a lot of fun. I enjoy the secretive 007 kind of vibe you get with them. Christian Cogdell says, what's the dumbest thing you've ever done in Fallout? I mean, there are too many to recount here. I think the dumbest thing that I habitually do and continue to do is when I'm using a weapon that has explosive ammunition, like spray and pray. Shooting at an enemy that's too close to me so that I kill myself. Like when I get rushed by a ghoul, the fight or flight thing kicks in and then I don't think about it. I just immediately start shooting this ghoul without realizing that it has explosive damage and that it's gonna kill me. And so, I mean, I do that all the time. It's like every time I play that character, I kill myself. So I published a video on the Commonwealth Provisional Government today, and it was a lot of fun. I not only had a lot of fun creating that video, but I've really enjoyed reading all of your comments. But there is one thing I want to make clear. The massacre of the CPG is a completely different moment in time from the Broken Mask incident. Two different incidents. So the Broken Mask incident was when a synth eating noodles at Power Noodles in Diamond City froze, went haywire, and then went on a killing rampage, right? He was killed by Diamond City security, and they discovered a synth component in his head. That was when they first realized that synths exist and that synths look like human beings. This was an early model Gen 3 synth that did the Broken Mask incident, because if it wasn't, then it wouldn't have been able to blend in as a human being. The entire reason Nick tells us this story is that people in the Commonwealth are afraid of Gen 3 synths because Gen 3 synths look like human beings, which they learned from the Broken Mask incident. That's the entire point. Sorry, just had to moderate some comments. Liam says, Oxhorn, when is your Minuteman video coming out? I know you're all really excited. Give me time, please. I have a lot that I'm building up to. I did a video on Preston Garvey, which is giving me footage I need for the Minuteman video. I did a video on the Commonwealth Provisional Government, which is giving me footage I need for the Minuteman video. I did a video on the Super Duper Mart, more footage for the Minuteman video. I'm working my way there, but give me time. Anyway, so when we are in the Institute and we find the director's holotape number 108, not only is it in a completely different number sequence from the other one that talks about the massacre of the CPG, that was number 52, this other holotape was number 108. So that's significantly closer in time towards the present than the one that we find. But not only that, but also we learn that the Broken Mask incident was a mistake. The synth went haywire, right? But we have no evidence that any synth went haywire in the massacre of the CPG, which also brings up an interesting question. Why was there a synth at the massacre of the CPG to begin with? After all, if you're the Institute and you're sending a representative to a meeting of the Commonwealth Provisional Government so that your needs are heard, are you going to send a scientist or a member of the directorate who obviously knows more about what the Institute needs, or are you going to send a synth? A synth that you sarcastically refer to as no better than a Nuka-Cola machine. You're going to send a human being, right? You're not going to send a synth. Synths are soldiers, they're coursers, they're janitors, they're not diplomats. They're not members of the directorate. They don't have any organizational or leadership skills in the Institute. They're not seen that way. Additionally, the only person that we ever have evidence of being at a CPG meeting is the voice of the man who sent the holotape to Father. That man was a human being. He wasn't a synth. So why would they be sending a synth to the CPG in the first place unless they were sending a synth as an assassin? So if we're going to assume that the synth went haywire, kind of like the whole Broken Mask incident, we first have to answer the question why the synth was there to begin with, when it was much more likely that they would have sent a human. Ben says, is he doing this at 3:30 in the morning? I love it. It may be 3:30 in the morning for you, but for me it's 7 o'clock. 7:30 actually. And I have to apologize. I'm starting the show late today. I was in the middle of working on my video for tomorrow and I'm not done with it yet. So I ended up starting the show late. But here we are. Mini Trot says, I haven't been here in a while. Did you get a different background? No, this is the same background I've had for over a year and a half, almost 2 years now. K-Vile says, Oxhorn, any lived-in settlement builds? Yeah, I am going to be going through every single settlement and doing a lived-in settlement build, so never you fear and don't you worry, I will get through them all. My video for tomorrow, however, is on an extremely cool mod called Transfer Settlements by, by C. Dante. And I've been chatting with him while he's been working on it because, I told him that there were a few bugs that I found. And so he's been sending me early releases of the mod, to test out on my machine before he publishes them. to Nexus mods. So the cool thing about C. Dante and his work on Transfer Settlements is he is dedicated to its success. He is working really hard to make sure that it's that it works well. But anyway, my video for tomorrow is on Transfer Settlements, and I'm going to show you how to use the mod to transfer a settlement from your game to a completely different game save. It is such a cool mod. It's so much fun to use. Anyway, I've been working on that all day, and I almost forgot about the show. But I didn't forget. Here I am, ladies and gentlemen. Cheers. But I almost forgot. Yes, we have beer. Yes, we have cigars. But we need scotch. I've got some Glencullen, which is a brand new bottle. But then I also have some of this Glenfiddich. As you can see, we have been loving this bottle well. I've probably been sipping on this one for 3 or 4 weeks now. Let's finish off this bottle before we move on with the program today. Oh, my ice is melting. Let's get rid of that water. And there we have it. A nice final serving of the wonderful 12-year-old Glenfiddich. You served us well, oh admirable bottle. Can you do a video on the Gunners? Yes, the Gunners is certainly a faction that I have been meaning to do a video on, but I really need to get through the first, Hey! Oh, C. Dante is saying, thanks for the shout out. I didn't realize you were watching the show, C. Dante. 1.2b is out, he says, on the Nexus. Great. So I will be downloading his latest version for the video that I'm working on tomorrow. I can't wait to show you guys this mod. It's going to be revolutionary. Talk about, you know, there are so many people who said, there's so much negativity out there about gaming and certain games and Fallout 4 in general that people just like, they like to be downers. They say, oh, Fallout 4 ruined the lore of Fallout, and oh, the Fallout 4 modding community is dead, and oh. And then a mod like this comes out and completely reinvigorates the entire modding community. New mods come out for Fallout 4 every single day. It's far from dead. Bethesda just recently released numbers saying that Fallout 4 was their best-selling game of all time. And yes, that includes Skyrim. Yes, Fallout 4 beats Skyrim. I understand where all this negativity comes from. It denies the facts, and it just tries to rob the joy that so many people get from playing this game. It's annoying. All right, what was I doing? Oh yeah, scotch. Wait, I already did this, didn't I? Better do it again to make sure. The Adam Cat says, please do a video on the Hobologists. I will do a video on the Hobologists eventually, don't worry. There are quite a lot of factions in the game to get through. I've got my Miniman video coming up. I did one on the Adam Cats, but I do need to do some on some of the other factions in the game. But never fear, one and all, never fear, I will get to it. What recording software do you use? And I lost the name because it flew off the screen. I use Open Broadcast Recorder, or Open Broadcast Software, OBS. It works great. It's finicky. You gotta tweak the settings to get it to work on your machine. Like the default settings for OBS are for broadcast. So if you try using OBS without tweaking the settings, you're going to get really low resolution footage. However, you can tweak the settings so that it works for publishing videos to YouTube, which need to be in high definition, but it's just a little bit tricky. But if you can get through that, it's a great piece of software. Ben Lewis says, what's going to happen when you've completed all of the lore in the game? I'm not going to. Like, there's no end to this. There's an inexhaustible source of ideas that I can produce for Fallout 4. And so I won't be getting to an end. That said, I will be playing Mass Effect Andromeda when it comes out, which is this month. And so we'll see if that is a great place for new content. Caliver says, Oxhorn, will you be doing a video on every single follower individually? Referring to that video you did for Preston. Or will you be doing only videos for those who have important backstories? No, I will be doing one for every single companion that you can get in the game. I've already done one for Kate and for Preston, but I've been reading up on Hancock and MacReady and a bunch of other companions that you can get, and they all have really interesting stories. And so, of course, those stories need to be put to film. So don't worry, I will be doing those videos. But, you know, I do a video every day, and it's still taken me a while to get through all of the different topics possible. So give me time, and I will get through it. Please, is this request hour? Everyone's making requests. Please do a video on the South Boston Preparatory School. Yes, I will. Don't worry. It's on my list. I have a very large list. It's huge. It's like 15 pages of ideas. So for those of you saying, hey, what are you going to do when you run out of ideas? I'm not going to run out of ideas. I started making videos over a year ago for Fallout 4. When I started, I had 5 ideas. A year later, I have 15 pages of ideas. So a year from now, I'm going to have 150 pages of ideas. There's no shortage, ladies and gentlemen. It never ends. What's the worst weapon you've used in Fallout? The Acid Soaker. From Nuka World. Why does that exist? It just insults my soul. The Acid Soaker. Why does that exist? It is so dumb. Bam Bam says, yes, it's request hour. Is it? All right. I'll take your word on that. Please do a profile for Elder Maxon, says Louis Benna. That would be interesting. I went into him in my video on why the Brotherhood of Steel is evil. I covered him pretty thoroughly. But there's a lot more that I could say, especially his history in Fallout 3, which I barely touched upon in that video. So yeah, don't worry, I'll do that someday. A lot to do before then, though. How about the paddle ball, says Umar. The paddle ball is a lot of fun. I did a video on all of the Nuka World weapons, and so I did the paddle ball with all of the different add-ons that it has, all of its mods, and it's a lot of fun. Just walking up to people and bouncing them in the face with the paddle ball, and then watching them explode is great. Ridiculous, but great. Yes, the Thirst Zapper is also a useless weapon. Aside from that, pipe weapons are horrible. We all know that. I love the combat rifle. I'm not too fond of the sniper rifle. Because any other gun is better than the sniper rifle. The lever action rifle is a better sniper rifle. The Gauss rifle is a better sniper rifle. It's only useful mid-game, like early to mid-game. The Enchilada Kid says, how many times have you reinstalled a Fallout because of glitches? None. I've never reinstalled the Fallout. I don't know if I'm just lucky or if The way I play is careful, but I've never corrupted a game save. Whenever I install mods, I always test them out before I decide to keep that game save. If I ever run into an issue with a quest, I just use console commands to get around it. Like in Vault 81, for example, if for some reason Kathy is not giving me the quest to get the Grognak magazine, I just use console commands to advance the stage of the quest. So I've never had to reinstall Fallout. I've never bricked a save. I've never experienced that. Lee Gates says the handmade rifle is the best. It's a lot of fun. What about the Institute rifle? There you go. Nikan, that's a good point. The Institute rifle is pretty much crap. It's horrible. It's a horrible weapon. I even bring that up in my Why the Institute is Evil video. You've got this organization dedicated to science, and the only new weapon that they produce in 200 years, the Institute rifle, is worse than the pre-war laser rifle. It's worse. I wanted to use the Institute rifle for my Institute playthrough, and I just couldn't, because it's so bad. I even got a legendary one. I got Virgil's super mutant killing one, fully upgraded it, and it's just, compared to the laser rifle, it's crap. Hey, Oxhorn, did you know that MacReady and Jesse McCree have the same voice actor? Really? I hear it now. In my head. You're right! I didn't even think of that. I suddenly like MacReady a whole lot more. It's funny that they have similar names too. McCree, MacReady. I wonder if that was intentional. Oxhorn, I demand smoke rings. Thank you. You're keeping me honest. All right, let's do this. This is the good life, ladies and gentlemen. Sometimes you just gotta sit down, be quiet, and enjoy moments like these. My mustache is getting in the way. Dusty says, Oxhorn, you're the Gandalf of Fallout. Alright. Nikki the Cat says you should smoke weed for an episode. No, it's not my thing. Even though I am in Washington State where it's legal. It's legal here, but it's still not my thing. There we go, right at the camera. Umar asks, how many characters do you have, Oxhorn? A few. My first railroad character, my second railroad character, my Miniman character, Institute, Brotherhood of Steel. And then I have a survival character. Six. I have six characters. Oh, and the character I created for my... Metal General character build, so seven. I have seven characters. I never play my survival character. Survival is not fun. I realize there are many people out there that love it. It's just, it's not fun. I'm in the game for the story and the settlement building. If I want a survival experience, I'll just go play DayZ. or Savage Lands. There are so many survival games out there. I don't need a Fallout 4 survival experience. Also, it's hard. Survival in Fallout 4 is really, really hard. I've done a few live streams of my survival character on this show, and many of you will remember them. I'm so bad at it. Like, I tried to rescue Nick Valentine with my survival character at level 4, level 5, something like that. It was so hard. And then finding a water fountain with purified water in it is like, it's like a breath of fresh air. These guys get so thirsty. You walk from Diamond City to Vault 114 and your character is dying of thirst. That's not realistic. I can walk a mile or two without dying of thirst. What the heck? I respect those who can get into survival mode. Like, getting a level 50 character on survival. What is it the kids say these days? Mad props, boy. But I'm just, it's hard. I don't want to do it. Bipolar Gemini says, which one of your characters is the launch character or the oldest character? That would be Sweets, my level 160 some odd railroad slash Minuteman General sniper character. She was my first. She's the one with whom I build all of my Minuteman settlements. But I didn't do any power armor with her, which is why two of my characters are power armor exclusive builds. And I use them a lot for my videos. My Institute and my Minuteman characters are both power armor only characters. Outside of power armor, they're squishy. They're easy to kill. Shaden Samus says, that's how millennials speak. Morgan says, I just coughed up my water. I apologize. That's my fault. I shouldn't be trying to be hip with the fellow kids at my time of life. Gunslinger says, mad props, boy. That was so cringeworthy. I tend to do cringeworthy things, don't I? Yeah. Even in my Silver Shroud video, half the comments were people saying, ow, cringe, that beginning, Oxhorn, ow, that intro, ooh, cringe. Rex Armitage says, how do you think Dogmeat's family survived for 200 years, and how does he look purebred? That's a great point, because he should be a mutt, shouldn't he? It's very unlikely that dogs would have stayed in purebred lineages for 200 years. That said, dog meat doesn't have to in any way be related to any of the dog meats from previous Fallout games, right? That could simply be his name. Who was it that called dog meat? It was Nick, right? Nick is the one who said that his name is dog meat, right? Han Solo says, how come cats were not affected by radiation, but dogs were? Great question. How did cats survive? Cats are magical. Cats are not earthly creatures, ladies and gentlemen. Cats are aliens. They don't belong in this world. And Mama Murphy? Yeah, Mama Murphy also called him dog meat, didn't she? Great questions. Alpha says, why can't you kill dog meat for food? Look, there are two rules of video games. One, don't kill children. Two, don't kill the dog. I realize that you kill lots of other dogs in the game, but dog meat is like a personality. He's got a human personality dog. You don't kill the dog in a video game. What is your favorite weapon? I love the damage of the Gauss rifle, but I love the look and feel of the lever action rifle from Far Harbor. I think that is my favorite weapon. I love that it's got... So its silencer is just cloth wrapped around the front end of the barrel. I don't know how effective that would be, but I love it. I just love the way it looks. I love the way it feels. I wish it had a larger clip. But aside from that, it's a great gun. Okay, it's time to get started in Fallout. I'm gonna launch the game, but in the meantime, I need smoke ship ideas from you. So as you all know by now, in every single episode, I create a smoke ship made from nothing but the smoke in this mouth, based upon your suggestions. What would you like to see today, ladies and gentlemen? Is it a smoke zeppelin? Is it a smoke biplane? I guess it's a ship. Is it a smoke submarine? Oh no, Steam is updating. Crap. Is it a smoke galleon? K-Vile says the Titanic hitting an iceberg. See, that would just be insensitive. A smoke Lear jet. That's a first. A smoke tugboat. Moya from Farscape. Space battleship Yamato. The Yangtze. Yes, I realize I've gone dark. The game is loading. Give me a second here. The Black Pearl. I vote tugboat. The Winnebago from Spaceballs. USS Constitution, tugboat. Okay, everyone, this is the same guy as saying tugboat. The Death Star. All right, all wonderful ideas. I really like the idea of the Winnebago from Spaceballs. So that's the one I'm going to do, ladies and gentlemen. All right, pay close attention. It's only going to be in front of your eyes for a few brief moments. Here's the smoke ship. Are you ready? Okay, here we go. Whoa! Did you see it? Before your eyes, for the briefest of moments, was the Winnebago. From Spaceballs. It's a ship. It counts. All right, let's... Oh, there we go. All right, here we are. In the good old railroad headquarters. Let's see. Let's turn off my music and turn on the Fallout music. And we're good to go. So, quests. Let's see. We've got... Oops. Butcher's Bill. Go to the Dead Drop. North of the Chestnutillic Reservoir. All right. So, update. Since last week... I did the entire Vault 81 line of quests. and what else did I do? And I got the Grognax Axe, and I gained one level. So I played the character a little bit off screen, but I'm saving all of the railroad quests just for this show. So never fear, I won't be doing any of the railroad story quests without you guys here. So tune in every week to see them. All right, let's go to the dead drop. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. No, I don't have any points to spend. That's good. What do your perks look like? Asks Chesapeake. I'll show you. I'm doing the Assassin's build from Fudge Muppet. Their builds are stellar and astounding, ladies and gentlemen. I threw my own humble character build into the ring, but theirs are really the de facto builds. You can see that these are my base stats and that I'm going down melee and sneak. So this is an all melee build. I'm trying to keep away from using any projectile weapons or guns. It's been a challenge, but a fun one. The problem with this dead drop is it's right next to a random encounter location. For example, what was that just exploded over here? Huh. Oh well, let's go to the dead drop. The double axe, though. So this is actually a mod that allows me to wear an axe on my back. It's not an active weapon. It acts as an apparel item. ACC Grognak Axe. So I have the axe, but where does it go when I put it away? It just vanishes, but it's a huge axe. So I downloaded and installed the mod that allows me to wear the weapon on my back. The only problem is that it doesn't disappear when I equip it, so. Oh well. Dead drop time, here we go. Determine the status of the Augustus safe house. Uh-oh.
Augusta is still dark. Location enclosed. Exercise extreme caution.
Okay. Let's find it. Time to take down some raiders in the Augusta State House, ladies and gents. Please do a vid on Junkyard Dogs. I did a video on Erickson, the dog vendor, and also a wolf vendor from Far Harbor. But with Wasteland Workshop, you can now trap your own junkyard yard dogs, which makes finding Glenn really unnecessary. All right, let's find the Augusta safe house. Since this is my stealth character, let's be super sneaky about it. Okay, this is taking a long time. Let's run. Ryan says, hey Ox, how's it going, buddy? Thought I would just stop by for a few minutes. Wanted to say hi. Keep up the great work on this channel. Why, thank you very much. I'm having a blast, ladies and gentlemen, and living the dream. I'll be doing this for the conceivable future.
Huh? You're hearing shit.
Somebody sees me. See if I can get to the dead drop or get to the Augusta safe house before getting killed.
Hey, nothing there now.
All right, we got some sort of hospital over there. Oh no! Look, doggone it.
We're back in business. Really?
Oh, thanks, Deacon. Finally being useful. How am I supposed to get this thing if I can't jump up there as a melee character? Killing flies with an axe, is there anything better? Oh! That's a lot of flies! Alright, let's get the bloodfly meat. We can cook that up for some more experience. And then let's find ourselves some raiders. Okay, here we go. All these bugs, man.
Fun time incoming. Got him. See if they left anything useful for us.
Okay, got him. Deacon, buddy, that's the third costume you've changed into since we've been here in Cambridge. Hi.
Don't mean to make you nervous. You almost got away.
Here comes the graveyard, ladies and gents.
Lost them.
Woo! Up. There we go. The Mask 86 says, is he responding to Twitch or YouTube? I respond to both. I'm using Restream, which combines those chats into one nice, handy chat for me. Okay. Before we enter, let's, have I bound any of my... I don't think I have. Refreshing beverage. Let's make that... Oh, that was a waste of a stim pack. Oh, well. Kendall Hospital, ladies and gents. I like this one. This is a fun one. I should really do a video on this. Okay, what's in the terminal?
Yes.
Sweet.
Hey! Who's... Swear, I must be going crazy.
We must be very, very quiet. I'm a hunting wabbits.
Who?
What? Did I miss?
That was...
Oh, that was ridiculous. So much for stealth. Man, let's sit here and wait until my stealth goes back. That's right. That's how we do it. In the railroad.
Show your face! Come on! I dare you!
Don't worry. Hang tight, buddy. I'm gonna get you. Deacon, where you going? Come on, man. He's supposed to be the sneaky stealth character, and he's so bad. All these poor railroad agents. They killed everyone in the Augusta safe house. And a synth! What is a dead synth doing here? Does that mean that there was a synth spy in the Augusta safe house when the raiders arrived? Ooh. That's worth pondering. All right, Deacon, let's go to the top floor. You and me, buddy. Let us avenge our railroad brethren.
Going up. Sixth floor.
I don't want to teleport over there because... Ooh, a lit cigarette. All this wonderful glowing fungus.
Hey! Jet would be jittery. Yeah, she was right.
Oh, what is this? Oh, this is the baby ward of the hospital. And another synth.
Anything interesting on him?
What were these synths doing? Ooh, a bloody handprint. Oh man, these raiders are ruthless. A dismembered railroad agent and everything. All right, here we go.
About it. Stay calm. Wasn't your fault. Did what you had to do.
Deacon, I'm really considering leaving him here. He's gonna mess up my stealth, I know it. Alright, before we begin, let's take the bands off this because I know I'm gonna burn this cigar down in the frenzy of concentration that I have.
think someone's out there.
The guy with the missile launcher's freaking me out.
Come on, I dare you.
Deacon, do not catch his attention. Stay here. Just go over there.
Oh, I know you're here. I'll find you.
Man, some bottle caps dropped through. Let's go around this way.
Scared, huh? You should be.
Oh man, what think I can tiptoe over here? Oh man, Deacon, come on! That is not stealthy!
I heard something.
That is the opposite of stealthy. Let's just run across the bridge. Ah! Oh man. Deacon, you moron.
When you turn up, you're dead.
There we go. Ah! Ah! They found me. Bleeding missile launcher to the face! Okay, Deacon, where'd you go? You're staying back here. Where'd you go, Deacon? Huh? Where is he?
Everything's starting to sound like footsteps, isn't it?
Whenever you're done corpse squatting, I'm good to go.
Well, Deacon, buddy, I don't know where you went. You're supposed to be following me, but clearly you're not doing that.
Now, gotta do what I gotta do.
What the?
Hey! I think someone's out there.
Oh, man, please.
Back
don't
it in, boys.
Again.
There's nothing out there.
Well, I have no one to blame for that but myself. Ooh, did you see that? Stuck in his head. Melee is just brutal. Ah! This is is gonna be tricky. All right, this is gonna be tricky. We got this. I gotta get that guy with the machine gun somehow. How do I get over there?
Just noise. Just noise. Hey.
What?
What?
Hey. Who's there?
Who's out there?
One, save that.
Come on out. I'll make it nice and quick. You can trust me.
Two. Save that.
God damn it. If we're running, we're doing it without me.
Deacon, if you can just not aggro the entire zone.
Oh,
I'll be very happy. Okay, we're hiding over here.
Only a fucking coward hides.
I gotta get to those steps. That's where the missile launcher guy is. So let's go through this advanced locked door.
Sweet.
Show your face! Come on! I dare you!
The dog is on me. Yes, anytime! Swing! I do not want to be hit in the face with a missile.
Playing games with me, huh?
Hey, that's my trick.
Scared, huh?
One more. Yes. Now, I could care less. Okay, is that all of them? That may be all of them, ladies and gents. Let's find our way down. Ooh, capstan. Thank you. Ah, sad. The railroad agents are dead.
Got it.
I have no idea where Deacon is. He's off doing his own thing.
Rip on yourself. Someone there?
Okay, how do I get down there? Reaction.
What the?
This is where I just was, isn't it?
Just noise. What?
How do I get down there? Looks like I need to go around there.
Starting to sound like footsteps these days.
Oh, here we go. And I didn't teleport. I stayed up here. How is that even possible? Come on, man. Almost to the bottom. Oh no, I remember. Oh no, I'm gonna have to kill a Deathclaw. I forgot about that. I forgot about it. Oh shoot. How am I gonna kill a Deathclaw? I do have a mine on me. Maybe I can use a mine? We'll see. All right, this is going to be tricky. My bottle cap mind work. Let's try this again. Legendary one, too. Oh my gosh, look how much damage I'm doing to it. This is pitiful. How did I kill it? What happened? How did I kill it? How did that happen? It had full life practically. How did I kill it? A VATS enhanced 10mm auto pistol. Ooh, that may be useful. How did that happen? I have no idea what happened. I'm not gonna complain though. I'll take it. I will take it. Anything else down here? Piles of bodies, all these poor railroad agents. And out we go. Deacon? I suppose Deacon could have done it, but that's some pretty lucky critical hits all at the same time. Okay. And there's even more dead people out here. Dead people everywhere. All right, let's go turn this in.
Pam wants you.
Leave me alone, drummer boy.
Augusta's safe house was destroyed by the Institute.
It's as I feared. 3 safe houses gone. Hard to imagine.
I have nothing further for you at the moment. I'm sure someone else could use your help. No shortage of fires to be put out.
Great. Let's see, what else do we have? Set up a Mila. Yeah, let's go set up a... Oh, this Corvaga assembly plant? No. I'll save that for another day, because that's a big encounter.
Pam.
Confirmed. Agent Wanderer has arrived. I have a mission for you. Without increasing efficiency of synth traffic flow, odds of entire organization being compromised increase daily. Solution. A new distribution center needs to be established.
The distribution center? What's that?
The railroad organization calls distribution centers safe houses. A place where synths are stored and then rerouted safely through the region known as the Commonwealth. Mission details commencing. Pacify the target location. Fortify position to protect current and future railroad assets. New distribution center will be codenamed Mercer Safe House. Good luck.
Thank you. Oh, it chose the Starlight Drive-In as my Mercer Safe House. I think I can do that. Oh, dear. Let's go kill some enemies at the Starlight Drive-In. Kaiser says, Ox, do you always stream at this time? I stream every Thursday night at 7 o'clock p.m. Pacific time. Unless I'm a little late like I was today. All right, let's head on over. Now, I don't recall there being a whole lot of enemies here at the Starlight Drive-In, so what are all of these markers? Are these ghouls? They must be ghouls. Mole rats.
Anything interesting on them?
I love stuff. Uh-oh.
Don't look, but I think we're gonna look.
Really?
So close.
See if I can sneak up on the others.
Nice.
Oh no, that's the workshop. How many are left? One. One mole rat left. Let's get him. Okay. Oh, hold on, I'm getting a phone call. I'll save that call for another day. All right, we've got our Mercer safe house. Let's set this up. Build defenses. Let's get some supplies. You can remove the nuclear radiation by scrapping these barrels. Man, lots of skeletons over here. All these poor people dying while the movie's going on. All right, a few more cars. Okay, defenses. Let's set up some defenses here. How much supplies do I have? None. Barely any. I need to get some wood. All right, I got to scrap some trees. Okay. Is that enough wood? Yes. So there's a spawn point location over there. There's a spawn point location up there. Let's put one here for now. Let's see, did I get any oil? Oh, and I don't have the perks necessary. I need gears. I'm not gonna find any gears in here, will I? It's all steel. I scrap an entire car and I don't get any gears. I just get steel. Oh! Forgot about that. What would give me a gear? Well, you know what? I may have to do this another day because I don't have any gears on me. But there you go. That's my Mercer's safe house. I'm just going to have to put up some turrets and we'll be good to go. Okay, well, I'm going to have to call that a day. I still have a video to do, ladies and gentlemen, so stay tuned for tomorrow. Makeshift bombs give gears? Yeah, if only I knew that before I set it off. Anyway, so stay tuned for tomorrow. I'm going to be doing a video on transfer settlements, a really cool mod. It's going to revolutionize the way people deal with settlements in Fallout 4. So I'm excited to share that with you tomorrow. Be sure to tune in next week where we will continue our railroad quests and continue along the railroad quest line. And until then, ladies and gentlemen, I will see you later. And be sure that each and every one of you stays classy.